So in our previous video, we have updated our web API to add the methods to upload, delete, and set the primary photo of a property. Now we will update our frontend to perform all of these activities through an user interface. Property owner should be able to perform all of these activities using this view dashboard option. At present, all of the properties listed by all owners are appearing here. But on clicking this view dashboard, the user should only be able to see the property listed by them only. And if the user clicks this property detail button, a new tab name upload photo should appear here. And from this tab, the user should be able to upload, delete, or set the main photo of their properties. So in this video, we will add this photo editor component in our application to perform all of these functionalities next. Let's go to our frontend, and we are going to add one more component named photo editor here in the property folder. We can generate the component using terminal window in VS Code. We can open the terminal window in VS Code using Control plus backtick or tilde sign. As one terminal window is already in use to run our application, we can open one more window by pressing this plus sign. Let's go to this property folder, as we need to generate this new component in the property folder. Hope you remember, we can generate a new component like this, ng-g-c, g for generate and c for component. Then we need to provide the name of the component. Let's name it photo editor. Our new component has successfully been generated. And here, this new folder is created with all the associated file for this component. Let's delete this pack file, as we are not going to use unit testing in this tutorial. So our component has been created. Next, we will design it. Let's go to the TypeScript file of this component. As we are going to use this component in other components, we should be able to pass the value from parent component to this photo editor component. We will use this component on the property detail component. We should be able to pass the property info from the property detail component into this photo editor, so that we can display the images of property in this photo editor component. We can use the @ input decorator to declare the variable which are to be passed by the parent component into this component. As we need to pass property details as input, let's name it property. And type of this should be property. This class is already defined in the model. And we need to import this input decorator as well before to use it here. We can use control dot and import it from the angular/core library. This has been added here. That's it for the TypeScript file for now. Next, we will design this component using an HTML file. But before that, let's try to add this component in the property detail component so that we can see that it is working fine or not. So go to the HTML template of the property detail component and scroll to the bottom of this page. I'm going to add one more tab here just before the contact tab to upload the photo. Let's copy this tab and give it a caption, upload edit photos, as we are going to perform both of these tasks from this tab. Here we will add our newly added component photo editor, as we already have taken property as input parameter in this component. Just pass the property as parameter here. This property variable we already have in this property detail component. If we look at the TypeScript file of this component, you can see here we already have this property variable that we just passed as input parameter in our property editor component. And here in the ng-onInit method, we are populating property data from the database in this variable here. So at the photo editor component, we will get all the details of this property, including the URLs of the photos that we will use to display the photos associated with the property in our photo editor component. So let's save it and open the property detail page. This new tab has been added here, and the photo editor component is loaded into this tab. So up to this point, everything is working fine. Let's design this component and load the photos associated with the property next. So go to the property editor component. Here we already have declared this property input variable, and we are passing the property class in this variable from our property detail component. So this input variable has all the information about property and has the image URL for all the photos of associated property. We will use this variable in our HTML template to load the uploaded photo into this photo editor component. Let's add a div and give it a class row. And in this row, we will add a column and give it a size 2, so that 6 images per row can be displayed here. And in this div, we would like to populate images associated with the property. So we can use ng for loop and let's get a photo from the property dot photos. It contains the array of photo associated with this property. We will iterate through the list of photos using this ng for loop to get the individual photos in this array. Let's add an img tag and set the source of image using string interpolation by using double curly braces. And here we can use any TypeScript variable. We will use photo.image URL as the source of image. It contains the path of image pointing to the cloud. Let's use the same URL as alternate text as well. Give it a class img-thumbnail and give it a padding of 1 to add some space around the image. Let's add one more div just below to this image to add the buttons to set the main photo and to delete the photo. Give it a class text-center to align the buttons in the center of this image. Add a button and give it a class btn-sm to display a small button. Give it a caption main. Add one more button. Give it the same class btn-sm and one more class btn-danger to give it a red color as it is a delete button. We will use the trash icon for the delete button by using the font awesome class here. Save it and let's check it if it works. Yep, images are loaded, but it seems there is some issue in CSS that it is not appearing in a single row. Let's check it. Yep, seems here is the problem. It should be col-2. Let's check it again. Perfect. Now our images are appearing as desired with two buttons at the bottom to set the main photo and one for deleting the photo. But from this screen, we are not able to know which photo is already set as the main photo. Also, if the photo is already set as main, this button should be disabled for that photo. Let's update our template to add this functionality next. So we can use property binding here to disable this button dynamically on the basis of condition. We already have a flag in the photo object with the name is primary. So we can disable this button if the photo is primary. Means for the primary photo, this main button will get disabled now. Also, we would like to give a different color to this button if a photo is primary photo. We can use ng class here to set the class dynamically on the basis of some condition. Here, the first parameter is the condition. So if the photo is primary, Then we can set the class as btn-success-active to give it a green color. We can use the else part after colon. Why we are getting this red underline? I think we need to take it in single quotes as we already using double quotes here to define the class. Yep, now error is gone. Let's use btn-outline-success to make just the outline green of this button. Let's check it. Yep, now this button is getting highlighted if a photo is the main photo and other buttons are white and just green outlined. Also, you can see this photo is the primary photo. So this button is disabled now. So that's it for this lesson. In our next video, we will add the functionality to delete the photo from the cloud on clicking of this delete button, and also set the different photo as the primary photo on clicking of this main button. So stay tuned. See you in the next video. Bye bye.